Hello learners, welcome to environmental science course for senior secondary level in NIOS. Humans have lived in close contact with their environment ever since they first evolved back in time between 1 million to 2 million years ago. They were hunters and gatherers to start with time and common need for food security and protection from wild animals. Small tribal groups were formed. This gradually hard to a settle and well-organized life. Their number increased, and with industrialization, the exploitation of nature drawing more and more resources from also kept increasing. Along with this exploitation, there was also an unequal growth in the human society. Villages and cities formed, paving way to metropolitan or mega cities. Thus, the society get divided into rural and urban centers. So today we will discuss lesson 8, human societies, from module 3, human impact on environment, of environmental science course. I am Neelam Gupta, course coordinator of environmental science. Welcome you in this program. So today's objective of this program are: define urban and rural settlement, explain the push and pull factors leading to migration of rural population to cities, define rural settlement and list of characteristics of rural settlement, differentiate between rural society and urban society, discuss land availability and land use in villages, explain waste generation in urban areas, define slum and urban planning. With the discovery of comforts of food sufficiency through agriculture, convenience of mobility with the discovery of wheel and the security of living in a group, primitive human began to feel the need for settled life and make shelter for themselves. Actually, there was no clear-cut criteria to distinguish between the rural and urban societies. Their size and function forms the criteria for the division. Rural settlements are primarily engaged in agriculture, fishing, forestry, mining, craftwork, and weaving, while urban settlement starts with industrial revolution and also associated with non-agricultural activities such as manufacturing, trade and commerce, transport and communication, defense and administration. The settlements can be permanent or temporary. Villages and permanent aggregation housing are example of permanent settlement. Hamlet, few dwelling towns and cities. On the basis of their size and functions, permanent settlement can be rural or urban towns. There is no characteristic criteria to distinguish between rural and urban settlements. Hamlet is a settlement of a few dwellings, whereas large number of people settled in several clusters of buildings form town and cities. Both rural and urban settlements are example of permanent settlement. Now we come to the urban settlement. Life in cities and town in urban life. The traditional cities were built to separate them from the villages, markets, dwelling units, brick or concrete buildings for administrative bodies and religious bodies are common from rural areas. For employment, settle down towards the edges of the cities and live in shelters. With increase in population and time, the urban scenario has undergone a sea change. People coming from rural areas in search of job opportunities settle down in shanties in the periphery of the cities. Shanties are small houses usually made from pieces of wood, metal or cardboard in which poor people live, especially on the edges of the city. Urban scenario has undergone a sea change. Overcrowding, abundance of concrete structure and slums has become a common feature of the most Indian cities now. As the rural population migrates towards cities, there were shortage of water, affordable housing, public transports and other amenities that are necessary for healthy life. Their number increased, and with industrialization, the exploitation of nature drawing more and more resources from also kept increasing. Along with this exploitation, there was also an unequal growth in the human society. Villages and cities formed, paving way to metropolitan or mega cities. Thus, the society got divided into rural and urban centers. In spite of such difficulties and hardship, the influx of rural population into cities is continuing. Such unprecedented increase in urban population is occurring in almost all the countries, especially in the 20th century. It is estimated that by 2020, half of Indian population will be living in cities. This tendency of concentration of population in cities is called urbanization. The factors which push the folk out of the villages and pull or draw them towards the urban areas are depicted in the next slide. Push factors are few services, lack of job opportunities, unhappy life, poor transportation, natural disasters, wars, and shortage of food. Pull factors are access to services, better job opportunities, more entertainment facilities, better transport link, improved living conditions, hope for a better way of life, family links. This slide is on the screen, is an activity. You can look at the picture and try to compare what you see in a large city versus a small town. Question arises, what are the advantages of living in a large city, especially in terms of employment, recreation, and cultural activities? Second, what are the disadvantages of living in small town? Or you can think about it. But now we will list some of the factors that are responsible for rural migration. These are called pull factor. First, in search of better opportunities, villages have limited avenues for jobs or vocations. Cities have many and better employment opportunities. Cities are expanding constantly in terms of their territories as well as their trade and economic opportunities. This provides job option to a larger population. In last 50 years, Delhi has expanded beyond the eastern bank of Yamuna. Second is schools. Schools are not equipped many institutions in villages for higher skills or studies. City provides better schools and institutions for higher skills. Third one, better lifestyle. Social taboos, criticism, and superstitions act as a deterrent for the forwarding looking youth for improved life pattern. This attracts them to cities. Fourth one is to overcome poverty. Poverty along with slavery or bonded labor, malnourishment is single most important factor pulling the villagers towards the cities with the hope for a better life and job opportunities. So sometimes villagers are forced to move to cities under certain conditions such as war, famine, natural disaster, political or religious turmoil. Such factors called push factors force from whom to relocate or move to safer places. You may recall the recent disaster that struck Uttarakhand in time to 2013, and as a result, large numbers of village population was forced to. First is social heterogeneity. People from diverse cultural background live together as one community. This is because they all come with a common necessity for better opportunities. Second, freedom from social control. Loneliness and alienation of urban life encourages people to make secondary associations, such as the controlled social setup back at home is absent, and also because such associations look into their common need. And third one, clubs and group associations are some such centers. You can see diagram in this slide also. Individualism, multiplicity of opportunities, social diversity, lack of familiar and social control over decision or over decision making allows the persons to look more into self-interest and help in choosing one's own career oneself. However, one may also fail to make the right choice, so one needs to be careful. Fourth one is social availability. In a city, one is largely judged by one's achievements, competence, efficiency, and not the status at birth. Capable persons achieve higher goal in life. Fifth one is availability of facilities. Urban life provides improved health facilities, legal services, bank, market, malls, commercial belt, hotel, etc. All these facilities and opportunities come with a price. Urban life is more stressful one in comparison to rural life. The impact of migration from village to cities has not been all that promising. It has impacted their social, economic, and also environmental conditions. For example, the men leave their family and women, farm and pollution-free homes to live in cities as they have no money. They have to live in slums where their health, education, as well as employment scenarios may not be as bright as they expected it to be. This is a figure of a slum in urban area. The table on screen summarizes these impacts. Observe them carefully. Types of impact, that is social, economic, and environmental. Social, men leave the women behind at destination. Too many people cannot always cope with the education and health. Economic, no land for farming in at origin. Crop decline, no personnel for service at destination. Unemployment, economic insecurity, no professionalism or vocation, non-taxable, low salary, informal work. Environmental, slum development, at origin and at destination, pollution, trash, contaminated food and water, and marginal land. The sadness of leaving the village are echoed in the following poem. It can be a story of mine or yours. So that the poem is, I left home to come to school. I left farm to come to food. I left my cows, my sheep, but did not have time to weep. Now I know why I cry tonight, because I know now what I left behind and today what I hope to find. Cities full of cars and bikes, restaurants and bars and roaring mics, but I miss the vast sky and my kites to fly and my folk, my friends seem vanishing trains. So I cry tonight, but what I shall I gain? Now we will discuss next section of this lesson, that is rural settlement. What is rural settlement? A vast population in our country lives in villages and are mostly farmers or craftsmen. Earlier life in villages were completely different from that of city. Now in this era, you can see mobile phones, motorbikes, big concrete houses, and also difference in clothes worn by elders and those by youngers. This is because youngsters are not taking up their family vocation and are heading towards cities. However, when primitive humans began to lead a settled life about 10,000 years ago, their lives were simple, but societies were compact. The settlements were villages, habitation, and comprises of an enlarged primary group where everyone knew everyone else and participated in each other's social functions and events and shared happiness and sorrows. Such simple living and compact organization characterizes rural societies. So, again, question came to my mind, why are urban societies considered superior to rural societies? Answer, there is because villages have limited resources and opportunities. These are economically weak and inferior in skill and expertise. They also have low population density. And why villages are significant? Because most of the villages in different part of the country have preserved their specific culture and social feature. Now we will discuss characteristics of rural settlements. First is agriculture. It is the dominant occupation of villagers. Village economy is based on agriculture. Farmer hard to grow crops for the country. Figures below show large field for cultivation spotted by their houses in plains. Second is terrace farming. Figures shown below show large field for cultivation spotted by their houses in hills. Second is joint family system. Is typical of Asian, particularly Indian life. It is a social and cultural institutions found more in villages than in cities. See figure below. Third one is simple living. God-fearing and tradition-bound villagers led simple lives untouched by glamour of city life. Jajmani system comprises of jajmans who are landowners for upper caste and the service provider from lower caste levels who are paid in cash or kind. Caste system that stratifies the society is very important, is very prominent in villages, although it is not desirable. Sixth is rural calendar. Village people follows the Indian Samvat and the Hijri calendars. Seventh is poverty and illiteracy. Poor productivity due to fragmented and barren lands lead to poverty, lack of facilities in spite of welfare programmers. Welfare programs lead to illiteracy in villages. Eighth point is average to mobility and social change. Orthodox illiteracy, superstition, and fear of violating traditional norms keep your youth from taking new initiative or adopting any changes. Let us now try to tabulate the differences between the urban and rural settlement on the basis of our discussion. The table is on the screen and factor on the basis of which the differences are to be tabulated as listed in column 1. First factor is environment. Environment in rural area is predominance of nature. People directly related to the nature. In urban society, human weight environment, predominant, inhabitant isolated from nature. Second one is occupation. Agriculture cultivators and their families are in majority, few in non-agriculture pursuit in rural society, while in urban society, mostly industrial worker, traders, professionals and working in offices, mostly engaged administration, all non-agriculture occupations. Third is community size. In rural society, it is small, and in urban society, much larger than rural society. Population density, comparatively lower density in population in rural society, while larger population density in urban society. Social differences and stratification, much less due to similar vocation. But in urban society, differentiation pronounced due to work-related differences in earnings, different strata of urban society noticeable. Second is homogeneity versus heterogeneity. In racial, cultural and psychological traits, much homogeneity noticeable in rural society, much heterogeneity in the same country and same time in urban society. Caste system rampant in rural society, much eroded in urban society. Mobility, social mobility is low, migration of population towards cities mainly due to poverty much more in rural society, while social mobility based on achievement, migration towards villages low in urban society. Ninth one or last one, social interaction, primary contacts, more durable and sincere relationship due to simplicity in rural society, but numerous contacts and wide interaction, casual, short-lived relation, formal and mostly superficial. Now we come to the availability of land and land uses in villages. In villages, there are landowners who own the land and landless farm workers who help to grow the crop. In the landowner's land, land may also be needed for other purposes such as for road, building, industries, bridges, railway, track, etc. And land for these activities are reacquired against some compensation in terms of money or job opportunities. This has caused tremendous shrinkages of agricultural land and also changed the village landscape. Agriculture still remains the dominant occupation of the village. Modern agriculture technology has helped to improve the crop production in our country. Effects of modern technology on agriculture and rural life. Modern agriculture technology has helped to reduce more crop through the use of mechanized tool, expansion of irrigation facilities and use of agrochemicals such as fertilizers and pesticides. Traditional agriculture practices, tools and manures are depicted in this picture, and modern agriculture practices, tools and fertilizers depicted in this slide. Now we come to the intensive agriculture. that is enhancing crop productivity of the land with the help of modern technology along with unplanned urbanization, deforestation and industrialization have severely polluted the fresh water bodies and groundwater. They may be listed below. Runoff from crop fields carry soil and agrochemicals to water sources, thus enriching the nutrient content. This leads to eutrophication. This is a line diagram for eutrophication. Excessive irrigation leads to water logging and salinization of soil. This has an adverse effect on soil fertility. Excessive withdrawal of water from wells depletes groundwater in many areas, resulting in severe water scarcity. Pollution of water bodies has resulted in acute shortage of drinking water. Soil erosion caused by strike of sharp modern agricultural implements that loosen the soil and it gets washed down to river. It also causes loss of mineral nutrients to flooding. Continuous cropping on the same land leaves no time for the soil to revive through natural processes. The soil quality deteriorates. This is a picture of eutrophication. As I mentioned, we will take in detail in our next program. Urban life provides facilities as well as difficulties in Indian context we can talk about. India is a large country with the population of more than 1.2 billion. Youth in villages are turned to urban cities due to various reasons as listed earlier. Difficulties include lack of greenery and open areas, congested living conditions with poor air quality, lack of hygiene and sanitation, scarcity of water. All these lead to slum formation. Overcrowding also lead to social problems. Special problems of urban areas: changes in lifestyle and land availability. Rapid increase of urban population has necessitated expansion of urban limits. It has led to encroachment on agriculture field and forest land, growing townships invade productive crop fields and forests. Land use change irreversibly. Land is degraded, affecting agriculture field in the fringes of urban areas. High rising condominium, that is multi-story buildings, are surrounded by squatters and slums, which attracted new migrants, but inadequate facilities cause suffering to such migrants. Migrants from villages adapt quickly to urban lifestyle, which show up in their dressing up, feeding habits and interaction with others. Increased resource consumption in urban areas in the form of water, land and other natural resources is affecting ecosystems. Urbanization and industrialization generates colossal quantities of waste. It is a growing problem. For example, leaves, twigs, hay and dung, etc. Biodegradable waste can be recycled or used for biogas generation. Non-biodegradable waste are dumped in landfills. Examples: plastic, glass, electronic waste, batteries, aluminium cans, etc. This is a picture of landfill. Liquid waste from industries and domestic sector cause pollution of water bodies when discharged without treatment. Rapid advancing urbanization, growing shortage of housing has led to formation of large slums. Dharavi in Mumbai is one such example. Slums lack basic facilities and infrastructure. They represent worst form of environmental degradation, as they not only contribute towards environmental pollution but also suffer from crime and other social problems. Once the migrant reach the cities in search of job, they squat on vacant land and construct shelters from scrap material such as plastic, wooden plank, bamboos, jute, straw, bricks, mud, etc. Slums proliferate rapidly in unplanned manner. These kachha or pakka houses are built back to back and edge to edge, blocking adequate sunlight and fresh air. These are usually one room tenement occupied by several inmates. Slums are scattered settlement. Absence of safe disposal of garbage, a lack of pipe water and drainage electricity creates a very precarious situation. Slums suffers from fire hazards too. particularly due to short circuits and carelessness of residents. Urban planning bodies take a serious note on this growing trend. Increasing number of motor vehicles in the roads, industries producing gaseous pollutant causes air pollution, traffic jams are recent characteristics of metropolitan cities. It was a gradual transition from temporary to permanent settlement. First, they lived in kaccha huts and then pakka houses. Built roads, they first set up camps for a limited period as in the form of villages and later on urban societies developed. Before we wrap up, we would like to recap the main points, that is what you have learned. Society formation resulted when humans discovered the security that living in a group provides. They discarded the hunting, gathering culture and created human settlement based on size settlement, maybe rural or urban. Life in cities and town is urban life. There are several factors which pull rural folk out of villages and pull or attract to lead life in cities. Social heterogeneity, individualistic lifestyle, voluntary group formation, social mobility and availability of facilities are characteristics of urban life, but migration from villages to cities has had social, economic and environmental implications. Rural village settlement have characteristics such as agriculture as vocation, joint family system, caste system, poverty and illiteracy of villages are. Villagers make them orthodox and superstitious. Rural world and urban world differ from with regards of environment, occupation, community, size, population, density, social activity, etc. Modern technology has reached the farmers living in villages. Intensive agriculture has helped in growing more food, but use of chemical fertilizers and pesticides has degraded not only agriculture field, but also environment per se. Urban life in India has had its benefit like work opportunities, higher wages, availability of consumable, comfortable day-to-day life. Urbanization has led to increase environmental resource consumption and excessive waste generation. Slums and squatter settlement are a reality in cities. This upset urban planning and have specific environmental and social problems. Dear learners, this is all about lesson 8, human society. We will come again to meet you with a new program of environmental science. Thank you.